It's always very interesting when people use the term like save the planet, because I think the planet is fine. I think the planet will be fine without us. I think we have to save ourselves.
Hello.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, I'm Zaki.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Okay, both to answer. What is your stance on climate action?
The way I understand climate action is like on an individual level and collective. So on the individual, there's like, for example, like when we go to the beaches and like pick up the waste, or we are trying to reduce our personal waste or reduce food waste, for example. So there are things that we can do on an individual level. And then on the collective, it's like advocating, whether it's targeting like policies, speaking up about certain plans that might not be adequate.
I do not really believe in about advocating about the climatic change, because what if all the things that I've done, is that a goal or something that can make a tangible result? It is not strong enough to convince me that I need to go about doing to advocate for climatic change. Some supermarkets impose the 10 cents to pay for the extra plastic bags. I just say paying 10 cents, but I think it boils down to everybody's individual preferences. I bring the plastic bag or the foldable bag. It's not so much because I want to save the 10 cents, but it's more of my own convenience. So, a question for you. Why do you fight for climate justice?
Like, if you think about it, construction workers working in the heat, or just people who are like really working out there, right, compared to most of us who are working offices. So that lens allows us to understand that climate change affects certain people more. And I guess I fight for climate justice because I feel like those people are often neglected when we make policies or when we take certain action, and that we need to advocate for them as well. And through the process of advocating for them, all of us benefits. Greta Thunberg, is it?
Yes, I forget the name. Thank you for reminding me the name. Even at a young age, she tries to advocate and she really stands up for what she believes in. However, I still think it doesn't like resonate with most of the people. Everyone is responsible to fight climate change.
I do agree that everyone has a responsibility, but I also think that certain groups of people have a much bigger responsibility. And these certain groups of people are like politicians who can make decisions about like say carbon taxes. Again, I agree with the statement. I think everyone is responsible, even on an individual level.
I think that personally, not everyone is actually held accountable. For example, like why am I the only one playing the role of that to advocate for climate change? It shouldn't be me, but it should be like a collective effort, or
correct,
maybe the companies.
Okay, what will make you start fighting for climate justice?
If I'm or my loved ones is really directly affected by it. But thus far, I would safely say there's not much of greater impact on me. Alright. What would make you give up on climate activism?
It's challenging, for sure, because, for example, I think a huge thing that I advocate for is like for universities to stop investing in fossil fuels. The challenging part is convincing these people who have always valued profit to say, okay, we're going to invest in more ethical things and choose to profit less. I think very much the world is still very profit-driven, right? Like everything that we do, it's dollars and cents.
Then you will bring up about another dilemma where people, okay, I just do it because for the money. That could pose another challenge.
Yeah.
That people have that another perception to it.
But sometimes I feel like it's an effective incentive. I don't feel like giving up, but I definitely feel like it's such a big barrier to overcome before we can actually convince people to do something.
Okay. What do you think about the suggested actions commonly shown in the media under things you can do about climate change?
I do consciously do those things, but I also recognise that apart from it being an individual action, it's a part of a broader system. So for example, I can stop flying less on an individual level. It doesn't stop airlines from reducing the number of flights that go out a day. And I can reduce my waste, but even in Singapore, if you think about it, there's not much recycling bins around. And there isn't really proper recycling infrastructure in Singapore. So even if you do separate your waste, it eventually all goes to the same incinerator. The way that I think about it is like I can't change anything individually, but if my actions can influence someone else, then hopefully it will eventually become a much bigger demand that is big enough to change things on a systemic level. Yeah. Okay. Do you think we would leave the world in a better or worse place for future generations?
Okay, on my personal level, I think the world will eventually end one day. Okay, but yeah, so we can see because now this is getting warmer. Like you said, the sea levels is rising. I guess unfortunately, until somebody in power or somebody who really can advocate for climatic change, I think unfortunately the real truth is we may not able to sustain for a long time, or we may live with a worse state of. Yeah, living. I think with everything rising, even like petrol, even now, chicken price is rising, right? So everything affects, and everything's not getting cheaper anyways. Yeah, so yeah, I'm not good in predicting the future. Of course, I want the good things and be optimistic, but I think from the looks of it, it seems bleak, I feel.
Right.
Does this disagreement in opinions change how you view the other person?
I'm not here to like make you feel guilty about not taking action or whatever. I think there are different parts that we play.
Yeah, personally, I don't feel guilty as well. But just that it's interesting that we're having two sides of the spectrum, and I think it doesn't change that you are entitled to your own opinion, and I'm still entitled to my own opinion. So yeah, so it's okay to disagree. In fact, do you think you can be friends with me?
I think so. I think there are still certain things in common, even if we don't agree about climate action.
It's a respectful and engaging one.
Okay.
So, thank you for opinions.
Thank you.
Okay.